into the rezoning request of LP 2014-0226. I'd like to address. At this time, I'd like to address all those citizens from the city of Lake Park and our county neighbors who have been very vocal in this zoning request. It seems that this request has stirred up quite the hornet's nest. Emotions ran very high and the rumor mill was working overtime. There were people demanding representation by this council, people who didn't know they weren't citizens of the city of Lake Park, but rather they are living in the Lake Park area of Lowndes County. This mayor and council were elected to represent the citizens of the city of Lake Park. We do, however, have a moral obligation to work with our neighbors so that we can all prosper. The mayor and council share the responsibility to analyze and disseminate all requests and information that come before our city. It can be a daunting task when we're elected to carry out. So when a request for a zoning change comes before us, it is not a quick snap decision. First, this request goes before the County Planning Commission's administration. They analyze the request to make sure it meets all requirements before going before the Planning Commission. The zoning administration found this request meeting all guidelines and approved it. It was then unanimously disapproved by the Planning Commission. This is a two-step process. The city clerk received this information from the Lowndes County Planning Commission in a written form just the day before our city's first public hearing on this request. This is information needed to be studied by the mayor and council. To not do so would be a great disservice to our city, and in this case, our neighbors in the county. I am certain anyone asking for consideration from the mayor and council would expect the same due diligence. This council heard oral concerns at the first public hearing on this zoning request from county and city of Lake Park citizens, as well as the developer. At this first public hearing, there were moments of high tensions, outbursts, and threats yelled out to council members and mayor of not being reelected, not caring about property values, unconcerned about flooding, and many other issues. These types of behaviors were not a shining example of who and what we are in Lake Park. Frankly, I was embarrassed. This council voted to table this request for 30 days and then approved a second public information hearing at the elementary school, a meeting where all interested parties could speak. This meeting was, in my opinion, very informative, and the county and city residents had a great opportunity to interact with the developers and attorneys to ask pertinent questions. The majority of people attending this public hearing acted dignified and voiced some very good questions. Unfortunately, it has come to my attention that one of our city council members was threatened that if they didn't vote a certain way, their family business would suffer. The Valdosta Daily Times ranked rave was filled with negative comments towards this council, and rumors were flying that this council had already made a decision. Let me set the record straight. Tonight is the only time that this council will vote on this issue, and it is each council's person's elected right to vote the issue as they decide after reviewing all the information. Trying to rush this council's decision, trying to bully elected officials and their decisions, is both unethical and immoral. I love Lake Park, and I know this council does as well. This council service to the city is for the betterment of our community, and yes, the surrounding areas as well. It is only through cooperation between our Lake Park area neighbors and our Lake Park city that we can move forward and build a better future for all of us. I have confidence that our city of Lake Park citizens and area residents have that same vision. Okay, I got that off my chest. Thank you.